everybody, welcome back to Daily Easy English Expression, coming to you live from the United States of America. Yeah, thanks a lot for joining. You can watch this video, all of my YouTube videos, all of my podcasts for free if you go to my website, www.letsmasterenglish.com. If you click on LME Radio, Let's Master English Radio, the podcasts, both podcasts. If you click on LME TV, all of the videos that I shoot and upload to YouTube. So there you go. Check it out for free. Download the podcast. Keep them. You bet. You can leave a message. Say hi. Sign up for DDM. Yeah, say hi. Yeah. Anyway, so today's expression, very good. Actually, it's not. It's kind of scary. But it happens. The expression is, jump me. Jump me. Not just me, jump Tim, jump John, jump them, to jump somebody. Now, I am sure that you would never jump somebody, unless it was a joke. But maybe you have been jumped. Maybe somebody has jumped you in the past. That's so scary. What it means to jump somebody means to attack somebody. So especially the idea is there's a tough guy, a gangster with a knife or a gun, and he comes out, hey man, give me your money. And he jumps you, he attacks you. He takes your wallet, takes your money, takes your watch, takes your iPod. It's like a mugger. A mugger, somebody who takes your money, but they physically attack you. They beat you up. They don't necessarily need to take your stuff. They just attack you. Usually, they'll take your stuff too, but not always. Sometimes they just want to hit you and kick you. Maybe they don't like you. Maybe you're the wrong person in the neighborhood. It happens. Have you ever been jumped? Yeah, I was jumped once. Believe it or not, I was jumped, when I was probably 14 years old, just a little kid. Yeah, and I was riding my bike, and I was going down an alley by myself. It was daytime, and then suddenly, as I'm going down the alley not too fast, Bruce Smedock and some other guy jumped up. They literally jumped out onto the road and made me stop, and they took a knife, and they took a knife to my bike tires, and then they took a knife to me, and they said, what's wrong? Are you afraid? They were just teasing me. But they attacked me. Nothing happened, thank God. But I'll tell you, I'm not joking. From that day forward, I was nervous of Bruce Smedock. Bruce was a big kid. Very muscular, very low IQ. Yeah, you know, not handicapped, but just a dumb guy. And I'm sorry, Bruce, if you're watching, yeah, you're an idiot. Are you better now? Are you a good guy now? I hope so. You terrorized me as when I was a kid. Yeah, so Bruce, there you go. The truth is out there. Bruce Smedock scared me. I don't know what he's doing. I hope he's alive, I hope he's doing well, I hope he's a nice guy, but when we were young, he scared me. He was a scary kid, he jumped me. Now many times, if you are jumped, you don't know the person or people that jump you. It's a very scary situation, and sometimes you can get hurt. Sometimes people die when they get jumped. It's not a joke. Be careful. When you're going into a city, an area that you don't know about, you have to be careful. It's true. Let's check out a dialogue. How was your hike? Not so good.
Oh, I was so scared.
What happened?
Oh, I saw some punks. I thought they were gonna jump me.
It happens. Yeah. So I live near Las Vegas. Las Vegas, Nevada, United States, very popular town, people from all over the world come to Las Vegas for the entertainment industry. Casinos and shows, magic shows and concerts and amazing hotels. And there's a lot of beautiful nature. And people go hiking. And bad people sometimes go hiking too. So there's one trail near where I live. And I went once. And it was fine. It was beautiful. If you look up, it's beautiful. But if you look down, lots of trash, lots of garbage. And I'm like, what the heck is this? It's terrible. So I'm walking a little bit. And up ahead, there's like four or five guys. And this is like 2 in the afternoon, 3 in the afternoon. These guys were very drunk, drinking alcohol, very drunk. And once again, I got nervous because they didn't look like nice guys, you know, just five guys. And I was nervous that they're going to jump me. Yeah, what can I say? I mean, I don't have any money. I don't have any muscles. I don't have anything. All I have is you. But yeah, it happens. So in my life, how many times, actually, when I was a kid, when I was hiking once, in Korea, almost, not really, but kind of a nervous feeling, and a guy did come at me, but he didn't actually attack. He was drunk too. But we need to be careful. When you go to a different country, not just a different country, when you go into the city, Las Vegas, when I go into the city, there are places that I know probably I should not stop and ask for directions. Isn't that terrible? It is. It's reality. It's reality. It's not good, but it's true. And I'll say this, in Asia, and I've been in Korea and Japan, I've never really felt that I was gonna get jumped. Well, not like in America. So I've been to New York, I've been to LA, I've been to Chicago, I've been to Minneapolis, I've been to Las Vegas. In these cities, there are places that I would worry about getting jumped. Seriously. But I've been to Seoul, I've been to Busan, big city in Korea, I've been to Tokyo, I've been to Yokohama, I've been to Hong Kong, I've been to, I guess that's about it, for big cities in Asia. And I've been to all different parts of those cities, and I really never felt in danger. I haven't been to Europe, I haven't been to South America, I haven't been to mainland China or Russia, I haven't been to Africa, so I'm wondering, in your city, and be honest, don't be embarrassed, it happens. In your city, is there an area where you should be careful, where you might get jumped? Is there an area? Is there a place? I hope not. I hope you live in a very safe city. But if there is an area in your city where you might get jumped, leave a message and tell us. So that if I visit your city, then I'll know, okay, the city is beautiful, but be careful in this area, then that's good information. So is there an area in your city where you might get jumped? So once again, I live in Las Vegas. Las Vegas is, I'll be moving, but anyway, right now I live there, and it's a very nice, exciting city. But you might get jumped, especially in the north. They say North Las Vegas is a tough area. It's a rough area. And even by some of the casinos late at night. So if you're in Las Vegas, after 10 p.m., be careful. Yeah, be with your friends. Be on the main street. You'll be okay. If you're in Las Vegas and in the neighborhoods, generally I would say Las Vegas is pretty safe. But once again, they say, I don't know, but they say North Las Vegas. And I think specifically Northeast Las Vegas. A little bit tough. A little bit rough. Be careful. All of you guys, seriously, be careful. Don't get jumped. Always know your surroundings. If you see somebody up in the distance that maybe makes you a little bit nervous, pretend you're talking on the phone. Doesn't that help? Oh, yeah. No, I'm down here on 5th Street. Yeah. I don't know. Maybe that would help. I'm not sure. Be safe. Okay? Don't get jumped. And if you're a tough guy, don't do the jumping. Come on, stop. Get a job at McDonald's. A low-stress job. That's it. Have a fantastic day. Be safe. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye-bye.
How was your hike? Not so good?
I was so scared.
What happened?
I saw some punks. I thought they were gonna jump me.
How was your hike? Not so good?
I was so scared.
What happened?
I saw some punks. I thought they were gonna jump me.
How was your hike? Not so good?
I was so scared.
What happened?
I saw some punks. I thought they were gonna jump me.